Hey guys, your boy Begin, he's in the scene, and welcome back to another episode of FIFA Talks. Now, we're going to be talking about a couple different topics, including this new trend, which we'll be talking about in a minute. But first, let's talk about the game that happened last week, and that would be the Russia and Croatia Sweden and England game. The Sweden and England game, England did their finest to win this. And they deserve it. I really say that to, like, the bottom of my heart. Well, not the bottom, but, like, to honest to God, they deserve to win. England deserve to do it. And if they win, and if they go to the final, that would be something. If they go against Croatia, which will be televised on FX Channel 11, if you have DirecTV. I don't know about Time Warner Cable, but it will be televised at 11 o'clock on July 11th. And then tomorrow, which I am very excited to see, you have France versus Belgium game. So it's basically Belgium side. It's Lukaku, Fellaini, Hazard, Courtois, versus Dimitri Payet, Kanté, Paul Pogba, Antoine Griezmann, Lloris. And who else? And that's about it. So it's basically like parts of the Premier League players going against each other, and it's half the Manchester United players. So that I cannot wait to see, and it's at 11 o'clock tomorrow. At 11 o'clock, mark that as a on your calendars. Mark that on your calendars on the 10th, 11 o'clock, France and Belgium. Mark it. Marked that. And speaking of Belgium, they won against Brazil about 2-1, which shocked the world, because they were expecting Brazil to win the game. But plot twist, it was Belgium who fought all the way and managed to go to the semifinals. Now, speaking of Brazil, the last episode we talked about was how Neymar's acting skills were on point, and how the news thrashed on him, saying that he should win an Oscar for his amazing actor. He's basically more dramatic than Leonardo DiCaprio. Well, get this. I was on Twitter, and this last night, I actually found something. Okay. Now I looked up on a hashtag Neymar. It ended up being hashtag Neymar Challenge, which is funny because for those of you that have don't know, or those of you that have remembered from the Mexico Brazil game, Neymar just acting like a total fool of himself and making himself a commotion. That's why he's branded the actor on my last video. Well, it turns out that this is a new trend called the Neymar Challenge, and I'll show you when we get to the top. Now, this is what in the UK, and this is what the coach taught these kids.
Nice close control, lads. Close control, boys. Neymar! Oh! Oh!
I mean, you got to admit, and I hate to, like, do that to Neymar, even though he's, like, one of the best players of all time, but this is too funny. If he didn't do that on the Mexico the Brazil game, if he didn't pull that stunt, then it wouldn't be a thing or a trend, and I wouldn't be like saying this about it, but this is actually too funny. People from around the world are actually doing this.
No! Neymar did it!
So all over the world, people have been doing this Neymar challenge for quite some time, and it's actually funny. Here's Tijuana, which I am so in shock about on the halftime.
Yes! Yeah, I want Neymar challenge. I want Neymar challenge.
Game is doing the Neymar challenge to the half court, to the half field and back. I am so done. Now, speaking of which, here's some of the best. See, now this is actually funny. One more.
Neymar!
I'm sorry, guys, but this is... Oh, hold up. What is this? Oh my gosh. Okay, maybe. So you can look this up too on via Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook by using the hashtag Neymar Challenge. And hold up, what we got here?
Hey, come on, stay with me. Stay with me.
Power of Christ. Power of Christ.
So I bet you Neymar isn't having a good day seeing all of this. This is actually killing me. That was funny. Okay. So that's happening. And when Portugal lost to, I forgot who they lost to. Uruguay. When they lost to Uruguay, this is actually a bit of a shock to me. Cristiano Ronaldo is actually making a transfer to Juventus. And here's the feed right now. Real Madrid to accept Juventus offer for Cristiano Ronaldo. And here And here's what it says. You can look it up too on CBS Sports. You can look at the transfer rumors about Cristiano Ronaldo's move to Juventus. This is what it says. With Portugal out of the 2018 FIFA World Cup after a loss to Uruguay in the round of 16, the annual Cristiano Ronaldo summer transfer saga is upon us. Ronaldo has been linked in the past with a team like Paris Saint-Germain and his former club, Manchester United. But the latest team connected with the Portuguese superstar is one he's done some damage against. Juventus. Spanish publication Marca. Anyways, it's reporting that the Ronaldo is moving further away from the club and that Real Madrid is obligated to accept a deal. The publication went as far as to say that he will be wearing the colors of Juventus next season, barring any late change. Spanish program. I don't even know what I'm saying, but anyways, is El Chiringuito. The Quadiones? I'm shit at doing this. I think I really hate pronouncing things. But anyways, it's reporting that the player will move to Juventus for... Holy gee. $116.57 million. That is a lot. As always, during the transfer window, let's sort out this transfer folder and give you everything you need to know. Let me see. Da-da-da-da. Jesus Christ. Okay, so... So this looks like apparently the once great Real Madrid football player, the left wing of Real Madrid, is transferring to Juventus for some reason. I was expecting, like what the news said, like PSG or coming back to Manchester United, but I don't know. I have some mixed feelings about Ronaldo going to Juventus. I mean, I don't know. It's maybe me, but anyways. Cristiano Ronaldo is going to be in Juventus in the next season in the, I forgot what league this was. Oh my god, I need to catch up. But anyways, Cristiano Ronaldo moves to Juventus. I mean, good for him, but like, how is this season going to be? I don't know, but we'll see about that. Anyways, that's about it for this episode of FIFA Talks. Tomorrow, like I said, tomorrow is going to be France versus Belgium at 11. And then at July 11th on a Wednesday is going to be Croatia and England at 11. So mark your calendars for that. So this has been your boy Big E. He's going to be at the scene. Thanks for watching another episode of FIFA Talks. If you like this video, go ahead, give it a thumbs up, leave a comment, subscribe if you haven't, and I'll see you guys in a bit, so peace.